Blessed Tuesday morning, everyone. This is Pastor Maricar once again of 611 Bread of Life Manila for our daily morning devotion. And we welcome you in our Bread and Breakfast. So today we will continue to study in the book of Numbers. And now we are in Numbers chapter 29. But this chapter is also a continuation of the previous chapter, which is chapter 28. And it all spoke about the offerings. And this is where God spoke to Moses, and he himself ordered his people and commanded his people to bring these offerings sa throne po ng Panginoong Jesus. And this is God commanding Moses to say and speak to the people of Israel that they have to bring their offerings before the Lord. And we have seen in the previous chapter that God requires them to bring in their daily offerings. They also have their Sabbath offerings or their weekly offerings. They also have their new moon offerings or their monthly offerings. And apart from that is that God also commanded them to bring offerings in the appointed festivals that God has appointed for them to feast, to celebrate, to give thanks, to commemorate the goodness of the Lord in their lives. And now we are in chapter 29, and God spoke of three festivals that has to be celebrated in this chapter. One is the Festival of Trumpets, second is the Day of Atonement, and lastly is the Festival of the Tabernacles, which we have just celebrated last week. And we were really overwhelmed because indeed, as God's promise that his people celebrate this feast, God will really fill them with joy. And that is what we have experienced last week. And a lot of people, they really bring in their offerings, and people begin to offer their time, their fellowship with God during the 7 or 8 days that we have celebrated the Feast of Tabernacle. And indeed, we cannot get enough of this festival that God has appointed for us. But most importantly is that in this time of the year, in this appointed time or festival that God has given us, God has commanded us one thing. And what is the one thing that is very important during this festival is that we don't just gather together, we don't just celebrate, but we have to bring our offerings. So that is our topic for this morning, is that follow God with our offerings. Now we need to understand that even in Numbers and almost in every book of the Bible, God spoke about offerings. God wants us to offer and give our tithes and our offerings from the Old Testament down to the New Testament. And God also requires us to offer our time, requires us to offer our best to the Lord God. We need to offer our lives as a living sacrifice. Now why does God has to put things or put offerings like this, and that he requires his people to bring in offerings before him? It is because offerings are very important to God, and that if we really want to follow the Lord, is that we have to understand this principle of offering, because this is God's way for us to really, he really wants us to celebrate him, celebrate the very relationship that we have with him, because our offering signifies our relationship to God. Okay, the offerings also signifies the goodness of God in our lives, because without offerings, without the things that the people of Israel can bring before God, it means that they were not blessed. It means that, you know, they have no God that is sustaining them. They have no God that has been blessing them. But in here we see that God was really very serious with their offerings. You know, before they can even enter into the promised land, God has already promised them that they have to celebrate the feast, the appointed feast of God. And even in the wilderness, you know, despite that maybe they don't have much, they don't have all the things that they needed, but this is God seeing, God proclaiming to his people that I am a faithful God. I am the God who bless. I am the God that will give you and is able to provide all your needs so that you will not lack, and that you have something to offer to me. And so this is the assurance that God has given to man. That's why the first point is, in here we see that in verse 28, it says, the Lord said to Moses, this is God, it is not Moses who has revealed to the people of Israel. It's not Moses, it's not something that is directly came from Moses, that he commanded the people of Israel to provide or to offer their sacrifices to God, but it is God himself who commanded them. It is God himself, it is from the heart of God that his people must bring the offerings before him. And so that is something that we have to understand even today, that offerings are very important to the Lord, because this is how we can show our faithfulness, our fellowship to the Lord. That's why every day the people of Israel has to offer every day. Imagine that they have to have a daily offering, they have to have our weekly offerings, their monthly offerings, and besides that they have these different festivals that is requiring offerings. And besides that is they still have to bring in their wave offering, they have to bring in their burnt offerings, they have to bring atonement offerings, they have to bring a lot of things, you know, many kinds of offering. And this is just simply, you know, in our time today, even in their time today, they may have this feeling that it is very heavy for them to do this command from God. But you know, they have to comply, they have to do this, because this is the command of the Lord God. And God has a special reason why his people has to do this. Why? Because the offerings is their connection to God. You know, in the Old Testament time, they cannot come without an offering. They cannot come without, and they cannot atone for their sins without bringing with them their offerings. They cannot please God without their offerings. And so the people, the only way for them to connect with God is that through their offerings. And this is one way for the people to show how much they revere God, how much they honor God, how much they really desire of God. And I believe that this is something that we need to learn today in our time, and that is we have to follow their footsteps. Like, they really have this faith that they can and they are willing to offer everything sa Panginoon. And every household has to do this. Everyone in the household has to do this. They have to offer the firstborn. They have to do, you know, there's a lot of things that you will discover in the Bible. And so that in our time today, there's a lot of things that we also have to offer. And this is commanded by God. Even our tithes. It is something that really is precious before God. It's even our thanksgiving offerings, even our vow offerings. When we vow something sa Panginoon, like we vow something for the temple, we vow something like when we have our firstborn, when we vow something sa Panginoon, especially when we were still studying, like I heard a lot of these things from many Christian youth that they vow to God that if God will only bless them, God will give them more. You know, they will give their tithes, they will give their first fruits to God. But I don't know how much they really have complied, how much they really has given their best in their vow to God. But I tell you that our vows are very important to God. That's why we have to really give our best shot to comply and to give it. And the second point that I want to share to you is that we need to align with God through our offerings and our thanksgiving, because in here we see that in the enormous amount of offerings, imagine every household has to comply this. And so in here we see that in verse 28 it requires them of you know, numbers. They have a specific number to offer. They don't just offer something that they want to, but God is requiring, God is giving them a certain standard and requirement in their offerings. And they don't just simply offer whatever they want, but they have to offer something. If they want to, if they really want to celebrate the Festival of Trumpets, you know, they have to offer a burnt offering of young bull in verse 2, one ram and seven male lambs a year old, all without defect. And even in the Day of Atonement, they have to do the same, but with the addition of things. And also in the Feast of Tabernacles, they are required to bring in, like present an aroma offering and pleasing to the Lord. They have to bring in the 13 bulls down to the 12 bulls. Every day, God designates, God requires a certain amount, a number, a certain quality of offerings to them. They don't just simply offer what they wanted to. Now, it is because God wants His people to know His heart. You know, when it comes to offering, God is really serious with this topic. God will never and never lower His standard in terms of offering. Remember in the time of Cain and Abel, Cain has given his offering of his harvest, while Abel gave his best. He gave the fat portion. He gave even the best, the firstborn, to God when they offered. And you know, God is not pleased with the offering of Cain, but He is pleased with the offering of Abel. Now we might think like God is too much, like why He won't receive the offering of Cain. It is because God looks up to offerings very seriously. Even if by not being pleased with the offerings of Cain, He knows that Cain will kill Abel, but He didn't give an extra grace. He didn't give like to tolerate or overlook the giving of Cain, even if it is not according to His standard. No, even if this will bring death to Abel, to whom He is pleased, God did not lower His standards. But He spoke to Cain. He said to Cain that He is not pleased. It's the offering that Cain gave is not to His standard, and it's not due to Him, not due to our God. And in here we will begin to understand that offerings are very important to God. God is a God of grace, but in terms of offerings, God has a higher standard. In giving our tithes and offerings, God wants us to understand that He has a higher requirement. He demands the best from us. And so that in here we need to align ourselves to God with our offerings. Imagine His people, they have to offer every day. They have to offer, you know, even if things overlaps, you know, on Sunday, they have to bring in their daily offerings plus their, you know, even their weekly offerings or the Sabbath offerings. And if it also falls on the New Moon Festival, they still, on top of those two offerings, they have to bring that offering to God. If they have sinned on that day, they have to bring in their sin offering, their guilt offering. And if that is all, it also falls under the Feast of Tabernacle, they have to bring in the offering on top of that. And so this is how enormous the offerings are on those times. But we see that God has provided for His people. God has enabled His people to give these offerings to Him. And this is where obedience really works. This is when obedience really brings blessing. And we know that in the Bible, it says that obedience brings blessings. When God requires us to something, God asks us to bring our tithes and our offerings, we have to believe that God will enable us, God will provide for us. Because this is a way that we depend on God. Imagine every day, everything they do, you know, everything they have to do, even in their harvest, as they plant, as they rear their sheep, their lambs, their bulls, they have to think, yeah, that every day they have something to bring to God. And on this certain time, they have to have this portion, this number of animals, because they have to bring this to the temple. They have to offer this to God. So like everything that they do, it's all, you know, is centered to God. Everything that they do, it is something that has to give thanks, has to please God. Because the offerings, really what connects them to God, what really brings the connection of men to God. And even in their festival, whenever they bring in their offerings to their festival, it is to commemorate the goodness of God in the past, how God has provided for them in the past, and at the same time is their way to celebrate and to, by faith, you know, declare that God is going to provide for these coming days, provide for these coming years. And this is what we need. We need to align with God in faith, that in our offerings, we can please God. In our offerings, we can really show our dependence to God and to really glorify God in our lives. Brothers and sisters, your offerings, your tithes and our offerings, we give it. It's not just because the church needs it. Yes, our offerings will also be God's way to sustain the needs of the church, to sustain the needs of the priests, to sustain the needs of the Levites, for them to be able to serve God on their fullest. But most importantly, our offerings, our tithes and our offerings, is our connection to God. It is our relationship to God. It is our dependence to God. It is our faith to God. It is our obedience to God. And if there is one thing, the first things that we shall be tested as Christians, is it's through our tithes and our offerings. Many people, they give their best in their ministry. They have given their time, they have given, you know, their best. They're so good when they evangelize, but they overlook their tithes and our offerings. But I tell you, brothers and sisters, it goes with any other offerings that we can give to God. And so I encourage you as a pastor, I believe that this is where and what God is revealing to us. In these past few days and past few weeks, we've been celebrating the Feast of Tabernacle. And even in the time of the Day of Atonement, this is something that God reveals in my heart, that the church has to rise up. The church has to follow Him in their offerings. And that we need to reflect in ourselves. We need to reflect on ourselves. Have we given our best in our tithes and offerings? Whether in giving our offering of time, whether it be offering new believers to the Lord, whether it be offering ourselves, our fellowship with God, whether it be giving ourselves to God, these are all offerings. From our finances, from our time, to our efforts, to everything that we do, these are offerings that God requires from us. That means everything that we do, everything that we have, it should be offering. It should be offered to God, just like the Israelites, just like how much they really lived, you know, and thinking about how can they offer to God every day. It's something that God wants us to also understand today. And in our church, many of us has fallen short in this. And it's something that God also impressed in my heart, that if the church will not be faithful in their tithes and their offerings, there's no blessing that we shall be expecting. No blessing in the church, no blessing in the family, no blessing even in our community, even in the nation. Because, you know, in the Old Testament, even in Numbers 29, God requires His people to be faithful in their offerings, because it's the only way that the nation of Israel will be blessed. It is the only way that the whole tribes, the whole camp, the whole tent will be blessed. It's through their tithes and offering. That's why whenever they rob God, whenever they offer blemish, that's why when they hoard or keep offerings from God, the tenth is being cursed. And we see that in the life of Achan. We see that in many times in the Bible, when they withhold their offerings to God, the tenth is being cursed. That means it's not just the person who withholds their offerings, but it's the whole tenth that is being cursed. And it's not just in everywhere this person comes, it will be cursed. It will not be blessed, because he holds the curse in the camp. Now, even for us in the church, brothers and sisters, I really want you to open your heart to this. In your tithes and your offering, we need to be diligent on this. We must give it cheerfully, give it to the best. Let our lives depend on it. Because this is how the people of Israel treat the tithes and offering before. It's where their lives depend on it. Because if God is not pleased on how they give their tithes their offerings to the Lord, definitely the presence of God will not be with them. The blessings of God will not be with them. So brothers and sisters, this is how important your tithes and your offerings in everything that we do. You know, when we offer, we look at God. When we offer, we have to really depend on God. Giving your offerings to God is simply saying, Lord, we love you. We give thanks to you for all the abundance, for all the blessings that you have given us. We give our offerings to you because we know that you are the source. You are the giver. You are the sustainer. We give our offerings to you because we depend on you solely, not just even to ourselves, not just simply on our companies. But you're giving your tithes, your offerings, it will bring blessings, because obedience brings blessings to everything that we do, in all the things that we do. And this is something that many do not understand. They think that they have a lot of money, but even if we have a lot of money, if we don't offer, God is not pleased. Definitely what we have is not something that will give blessing, but it's something that will bring curse to us. That's why a lot of people who doesn't know the principle of giving, you know, at first they were happy they have a lot, but the happiness that they have is not something that is continuous. It's something that even brings curse, even brings loneliness to them. The more they have, the more they don't have security. The more they have, the more that sickness comes to their lives. The more they have, the more burdens, the more responsibilities they have to carry. Why? Because they do things on themselves. They never trust God. They do not depend on God to provide, to sustain them, to give security and provide for all their needs. So brothers and sisters, I hope that this sharing today will allow us to understand God is our provider. God is our great support. God is our security. And that as we offer and follow Him, obey Him to our tithes and our offering, as God commands in Numbers 28 to 29. Surely blessings will come. Surely blessings will come. And in verse 39, it says here, in addition to what you vow and your freewill offerings, offer these to the Lord at your appointed festivals, your burnt offerings, grain offerings, drink offerings, fellowship offerings. And Moses told the Israelites all that the Lord commanded him. And it's the same thing that I'm telling you today. As God commands us, as a priest of God, I'm reminding you, and that reminding you that this is God's word. This is the heart of God. God wants to bless you. God wants you to enter into His promised land. God wants you to enter in the promise of abundance in your life. But you have to be faithful to give your tithes and your offerings, to give your best to please God every day of your life. Whether it be offering of your money, offering of your time, offering your families, your fellowship with God. Give your best. Give your best. Because God wants to bless you. This is the door of blessing. That's why in Malachi chapter 3 it says that you have to bring your tithes and your offerings to God, so that the floodgates of heavens be opened for us. That He will show us great and mighty things beyond our expectation, that there will be no room enough for it. Test God. Believe in God. Enter into His promise, and surely you will be blessed. I just want to pray for you. Heavenly Father, we thank you, for we know that you are the source of everything. You are the provider. You are the giver. You are the God who has blessed us with all these things. You give us breath of life. You give us the ways that we can work, the strength, the health. You give us the wisdom to think on how we can be productive. You give us, Father, this body that can work. You give us the brain, God, that can think. You have given us opportunities so we can work and have salaries. You have given us these companies. You have given us great bosses. You have given us a lot of time. A time that we can work, till the ground. A time that we can have hope, that even if there were curse, Man was cursed when we sin. But you give us grace that today we can earn our living. Today we can see blessings come into our lives. And today there's a lot of things and reasons why we have to give thanks. Lord, we can never give back whatever we have today, whatever you have given us. But God, as you commanded us to give our tithes and our offerings, Lord, we wanted to follow you. We want to offer our best. We want to give thanks to you. We want to align with you. We want to follow you, God. But many times, Father, we fail. And many times we ignore your word. We disobey you. We were unfaithful in our tithes and offering and the way we offer our lives to you. Because God, we depend on ourselves. We think like when we withhold our offerings, our tithes, God, we can save more, we can have more. But God, we have seen how much we suffer. You know, curse comes in our lives. Our families are not at peace. Our hearts are not at peace. There's so many things that are happening to us. There's no security. There's no freedom at all. But Lord God, today we just ask, we confess that we sin. We confess that we have robbed you. We confess that we have taken what is due, what is for you, God, and we take it to ourselves. Father, forgive us, for we have fallen short in these aspects of giving our tithes and our offerings to you. Lord, I pray that you change our hearts. Forgive us, cleanse us, change our mindset. Help us, God, to get out from this poverty mindset, Father, that we are willing to let go, Father, and not to hoard things, not to withhold things from you, Father, for we know that we have a rich God. We belong in a rich family. We belong in a God that can provide. We belong in a God who cares and knows our needs. We belong to a God that is willing to give his best. Provide all that we need, a God that will never lack. So Lord God, I pray right now that may you strengthen our faith, grow our faith, especially in the place, in this aspect of giving. For we know that in giving, blessings will come. Lord, we know that in our offerings, even our families, our tents, our companies, our works, our country can be blessed. And so Lord God, beginning from your churches, Lord, I pray that you ignite our hearts, nurture our hearts to become faithful in our giving. Lord, I break and God, I rebuke all the things that causes us not to give our and to be unfaithful in our giving of our tithes and offering. Lord, I break all the spirit of poverty. I pray that the mindset, God, of being poor, I pray, Lord, and I rebuke the devourers of our wealth. I rebuke all this spirit of deceit. I rebuke, Jesus, our faithlessness, our unbelief. But Lord God, today I release faith. I release hope. I release the truth to come into the lives, into the hearts of your people right now, that they will rise up, they will believe, and they are willing to follow you. Jesus, be pleased. And to everyone who responds today, and everyone who has been responding for these years, they have been faithful giving their offerings. Lord, remember them. Set your eyes on them. Bless them as you have promised them, beyond what they have imagined, beyond what they have expected. And may the blessings come to their houses. May the blessings come to their companies, in everything that they do, in everywhere, wherever they go. May the blessings go before them, that they will not have room for these blessings. Lord, I pray this in Jesus' name, and I pray this special prayer. I release your blessing, your mercy, faith, protection, even in this time of pandemic. Sustain them and make miracles happen for them. Give them good health, Lord, and abundance of life and joy. Lord, we thank you. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So dyan po nagtatapos ang ating bread and breakfast. I pray that we could see you tomorrow. Have faith and give your tithes and offering. Test God, and surely He will never fail you. God bless.